Hello, my name is John Christie. I'm a professor of photobiology at the University of Glasgow. So why is it important for biologists to look at the inner workings of cells? So when we look around us at the plant scenario here, we see trees, grass, other forms of plant life, and we see them at the whole organism level, and they are comprised of many different types of cells. And focusing on how each of these cells work at an intricate level will tell us how they are coordinated to regulate the overall physiology of these plant life around us. So how do we understand the inner workings of cells? Well, probably one of the best examples to do this in a live situation is to label the proteins within a cell with a fluorescent protein that we can view under a microscope. And this way we can actually track the movement of proteins and their dynamics in a live cell environment. And the most famous protein that we use for this has been green fluorescent protein, GFP, from a jellyfish. So GFP won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry a few years ago because it has revolutionized the way we look at cellular biology and track proteins within living cells, tracking the movement of proteins within living cells. So before the use of fluorescent proteins like GFP, it wasn't really possible to, in a live situation, look at a cell and look at the protein that you were interested and actually see where it was localized visually within the cell. By adding this fluorescent reporter, if you will, onto the cell, you can actually monitor live trafficking of your protein of interest within a cell. So that has been revolutionary in our understanding of how the inner workings of the cell operate. So GFP has been great. There have been many different fluorescent proteins derived from GFP, but there are some disadvantages from using GFP. It's quite a large protein, so it can often cause some side effects if you attach it to another protein of interest. And also the fluorescence that comes from the GFP, so we can see this protein, requires oxygen to be in the environment. So trying to track proteins where oxygen is limiting is a bit of a problem for GFP and its derivatives. Something that we have been interested in is using fluorescent proteins as a reporter to track infections in plants or in mammalian systems. And in plants, we've collaborated with virologists that have incorporated a fluorescent protein into the viral genome. And by doing that, we can track the movement and spread of a virus throughout a particular plant. GFP is quite a large protein, and that means the genetic material that encodes that protein is also relatively large. And this is a problem when you want to use this for tracking the movement of viral species within plant systems. It tends to be too large genetically, so the virus recognizes this large insertion into its genome. And what the virus does, and this is why viruses are very successful, is they mutate and remove that foreign material from their genome. So we can no longer track the spread of the virus using this fluorescence reporter. In our lab, we have engineered a different type of fluorescent protein, which has been possible to overcome some of the limitations that have been associated with proteins such as green fluorescent protein. So the proteins that we have engineered have actually been derived from plant systems. So plants have a natural evolutionary diverse range of photoreceptor systems. And some of these proteins are actually fluorescent. So what we did was take a small part of these, one particular protein, and we engineered this protein to be a fluorescent reporter like GFP. But the major advantage is that this protein is much smaller in size, both in its physical size and also its genetic size. So it can become a more efficient reporter system for looking at viral and bacterial infections.